Hey everybody, Pastor Evan here. I'm glad you all can join us for another Kids Life Worship. You see, this summer, as we get into VBS 2020, it's a mystery. We're going to be looking at questions, all the different questions that we might have about ourselves, about life, about God. And we're going to be turning to God's Word to find the answers. So to start off today, I think we need to dive into worship. We're going to sing a few of our favorite VBS songs from years past. So go ahead and stand up and let's worship.
Spread wide, take me in like an old. your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout.
Today, we are diving into the story of Jonah. We got a little bit of Jonah's story last week in our children's message during our worship service. But the next 3 weeks, we're going to be looking at the story of Jonah and some of the questions that he asked. Now, I introduced you to one of my friends the other day. This might have been a few months ago, actually. But I want to make sure you guys know about my dog, Buddy. Now, Buddy is lying down on the ground right now after maybe getting a little too excited earlier, because Buddy likes to bark. I think I've told you all this before. Buddy likes to bark a lot, and so when he barks, he's going off because he wants to know what's going on. He's either checking in with the dogs in the neighborhood, barking at cars as they drive by, or people as they walk past my house. But Buddy is always wondering what's going on. But you know what? We have those questions as well. As things in our world get scary or confusing, when things in our life start to change, we start to wonder, what's going on? Now, Jonah had a very similar question. He was given a very tough assignment, and he wanted to know, what's going on? Why is God having me do this? What is he thinking? So we're going to dive into the story of Jonah, and then I'll check in with y'all afterwards with Buddy.
Last time, as we began the true story of Jonah, we learned that we always have a choice whether to follow God or not. And we saw what we can expect when we run from God. God is going to pursue us to bring us back to his purpose. We can't hide from God. Now let's review and continue the story of Jonah and the big fish. This is the true story about an Israelite named Jonah. Jonah was a prophet. A prophet would get a message from God to tell people. God often sent prophets to confront disobedient people.
Jonah, go to Nineveh and tell the people that I am going to destroy them for all their evil.
Jonah didn't want to tell the Ninevites. He didn't like the Ninevites. The Ninevites were the enemies of Israel. Think about how scary it would have been for an Israelite to walk into an enemy city and tell them that God would destroy them. Jonah did not want to go. He wanted Nineveh to be destroyed. So Jonah made a choice not to obey God, not to trust God. Instead of going to Nineveh, Jonah made the choice to go in the opposite direction, as far as he could. He got on a ship going to a city far away.
Okay, I'm in the clear. What's up, guys?
He went below in the ship to hide from God, and he fell asleep. So even though Jonah was a man of God, he tried to run from God. Do you think you can run from God? Do you think you can hide from God? Well, Jonah was trying to run and hide from God. God sent a huge storm to wake up his prophet. Afraid they would die in the storm, the desperate sailors shouted to their gods for help and threw things overboard to make the ship lighter. The sailors believed that Jonah must have upset God and that God was causing the storm. And all this time, Jonah was sound asleep.
Wake up! How can ye sleep at a time like this? Cry out to ye gods so that we may be saved. What have ye done to bring about this terrible storm? Who are you? And what have ye done caused it?
I'm an Israelite. I worship the one true God. What I've read from you.
The sailors were terrified hearing this.
Why have you done this? What can we do to stop the storm? You could throw me overboard and the storm would stop, and then this terrible storm has come because of me.
They tried hard to row the boat ashore, but they couldn't make it. The storm was too strong. Then they shouted out a prayer to Jonah's God, the one true God.
Lord, please don't make us die because of this man's sin. Please don't blame us for his death. Stop! Just throw me overboard. I know this is all my fault.
Then they picked up Jonah and threw him overboard into the raging sea, and the storm stopped. The men stood there in awe before God. They sacrificed to him and vowed to serve God.
We will serve you, God.
As Jonah was sinking in the sea, God arranged for a big fish to swallow Jonah. Out of God's grace, God saved Jonah from drowning. Jonah was in the big fish for 3 days. Fish, Jonah prayed and thanked God for saving him and not abandoning him. Jonah promised.
God, thank you for saving me. When I had lost all hope, you saved me. I promise I will obey you from now on.
Then God commanded the big fish to spit Jonah out onto dry land. After praying to thank God for saving him, Jonah finally chose to obey and go to Nineveh. This story teaches us that nothing can stop God's plan. We can't run or hide from God. God sees everything. We will never regret choosing God's way. God knows what he has planned, even when we don't. God had a plan, even when Jonah was inside a big fish.
Well, I hope you all enjoyed that presentation of the story of Jonah. We're going to be watching the rest of that for the next couple weeks. But Jonah had some questions, and his question was, what's going on? Why is God sending me to Nineveh? He didn't really trust God's plan. He maybe didn't think that God had a good plan for him. But we know that God has the best plans. Now, here's my friend Buddy. And Buddy, he likes to bark a lot. And Buddy, when you're barking, you're freaking out, aren't you? You're kind of scared that the person outside or the car outside is going to come in and invade our house. That can get kind of scary, can it? But I want you to know, Buddy, that I'm going to keep you safe, that you're going to be fine no matter what, because I love you. And just like that, God cares about us. God has plans for us that we have no clue about. But God has good plans. He is in control. Just like he had a plan for Jonah, he's got a plan for you and me, even in this scary, difficult time we're going through. As we wonder what's going on, we can know that God is in control. I want y'all to join with me as we sing this next song, Jeremiah 29:11-12. It's a reminder that God has great plans for us, and we can trust in Him. Thank you again for joining us for Kids Life Worship.
I know the plans.